Hello, Kababayan, and hello, YouTubers. Today, we're going to be discussing the new updates that occurred on April 1st, 2022. Now, this one is pertaining to foreign nationals. So, starting and effective on April 1st, 2022, you no longer need an EED to enter the Philippines. So, you don't need the entry exemption document. Provided you comply with immigration requirements and fall under the following categories. So here's the categories. So listen up. You got to be fully vaccinated unless you are under 12 years old. You got to carry and possess a proof of vaccination. And it has to be an acceptable proof of vaccination. And you need to get a 48-hour RT-PCR test or the 24-hour antigen test before you take off on your departure. And when you arrive in the Philippines, on the day that you arrive, on that same day, your passport must be at least 6 months valid or more. Okay, minimum 6 months on the day you land in the Philippines. You're going to need travel insurance, at least coverage of $35,000, specifically for COVID. And also, you need a return ticket. You need, so if you are coming from an EO-408 country, for example, like America, which you guys already know, America is a visa-free. And Canada, that's visa-free. So if you're coming from a place that are visa-free or a EO-408, or let me expand on that. So if your country is in that EO-408 list, which you can Google for yourself, Google it, EO-408. If your country is in that list, then you could come to the Philippines for 30 days, but you need a return ticket. Okay, so you're going to need a return ticket. Now, if you are coming from a different situation, not part of the EO-408, let's say you're coming from a visa-required country, then you need a return ticket, but based on your visa. If your visa, say, it states that you can stay for 3 months, then your return ticket should reflect 3 months that you're going to leave the Philippines. If your visa says you can stay 35 days, then on the 35th day, you need to be able to return or leave the Philippines. All right? So because you have a visa, we can't say it's 30 days because it depends on your visa. So whatever your visa says, your return ticket will reflect that. So those are the changes for the foreign nationals, especially for a country. You're coming from a country that's non-EO-408. You no longer need a EED to come to the Philippines. Now, let's go back to what it says about you don't need an EED provided that you must comply with immigration requirements and fall under the following categories. I know you still need a visa. So if you're coming from a non-EO-408 to come to the Philippines, you may not be required to get an EED, but you'll be required to have a visa. And get that visa from where you're at right now, okay, from that embassy or consulate, get your visa, then you can fly to the Philippines. And then your visa, whatever days they allow you to stay, you still need a return ticket. And that's pretty much it. It's still the same thing as before, but quite a small difference now because they got rid of the EED. But you still need the insurance and return ticket. All right. And if you're coming from a non EO-408, of course, you're visa free. You don't need no visa to come to the Philippines. You come to the Philippines for 30 days, you still need to show a 30-day, the 30th day return ticket. So that's the new rules right now. This is not about people that's coming with a Filipino spouse. Now, this is different. Now, if you are a foreigner traveling with your Filipino spouse, go to the other video that I just made. That's the rules that you're going to be following. Okay, I just want to separate these topics. All right, guys, so that's it. That's it for now, guys. All right, have a nice day. And if you guys have any questions, leave me a message. And I'll point you at the right direction. And when I have time, I'll respond to your messages. Thanks so much for listening. I love you guys. I love you, Kababayan. I love you, YouTubers. Peace out.